What if we're drawing an O-ring or a spring that doesn't have any flat surfaces? In this episode, we're going to learn how to do this. So let's get started. Remember, go File, New, Part, Options, Document Properties, Units, and I'm going to select Inches. We're going to use the top plane, right click, Sketch. We're going to make an O-ring of 3 inches in diameter. In order to define the O-ring, we have to pick either the front or right plane because they're perpendicular to the circle that we drew. So let's pick the front plane. Now we can draw on this plane. And we're going to draw another circle that shows the diameter of the actual O-ring. And in this case, we're going to make an 1/8 inch ring. The problem is it doesn't intersect the circle. So we need to add a relation to show that. Add relation. We're going to pick this circle, and then we're going to pick the center of that circle, and we're going to select pierce. We're going to select pierce because the larger circle pierces through the center of a smaller circle. Now we just need to exit this sketch. We go to Features, and we're going to select Swept Boss Base. And watch how interesting this is. So our defining circle is Sketch 2 for the profile. And then we're also going to select this one for the path that that profile is going to take. And you can already see we've now created an O-ring. Now, something we haven't really discussed is the look of this 3D model. Let's just change it quickly so it looks more like a real O-ring. We can go over to Materials, right-click on Material, Edit Material, and we're going to go down and we're going to look for rubber. And I'm going to pick silicone rubber. And we're going to apply. Close out of this. And now you can see it's black and it looks more realistic. This feature is really handy if you plan on doing realistic photos. Now let's take a look how we can make a spring. We're going to open New, Part. Now our unit should be already set, but just to reiterate so that you guys don't forget. And no, it isn't. So we'll select Inches. I'm glad I checked. So we're going to right click on our front plane, select Sketch. We're going to draw another circle. We're going to make this one 4 inches. We'll pretend that it's a car spring. This time we're just going to go to Features, Curves, and select Helix. Now our pitch, we can make 1/2 inch. We can do 20 revolutions. And if we move it sideways, you'll see we now have a spring. Let's stretch it out a little bit. Let's make the pitch 1 inch. And we'll do 15 revolutions. That looks more like a car spring. So now we have our basis for our spring, but we haven't actually drawn anything. Let's keep going. Just like we did with our O-ring, we now have to pick a plane. Let's pick the top plane. Select Sketch, and we're gonna do the same thing we did the last time again. We're gonna dimension it. We'll make this 1/2 inch. There it is. Close that out. We're going to add a relation. We're going to hit the center of the circle, and we're going to hit our spiral. Again, we have pierce, and you can see it's already in the center of the spiral helix. So let's get out of there and exit the sketch. We're going to select Features. We're going to sweep again. Already knows that you want to use that circle, and for the second, we're going to select the helix. And there we have it. We could go further and close the ends, but this is a 5-minute tutorial, so we'll end it here. Thank you for watching this episode of Invention Therapy, and don't forget to subscribe.